Hi everyone, welcome to this Getting Started tutorial about the Angular AutoComplete component. Imagine that you are going to enter the employee name, but you remember only the partial name. At that time, a suggestion list of names relevant to your partially typed-in text would be of great help, just like how Google helps its users. Here is the Angular AutoComplete component of Syncfusion that allows you to display a relevant suggestion list for the typed-in characters. You can also bind JSON and remote data to AutoComplete, filter, group, as well as customize its UI with templates. Now, let me show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool, edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and finally, view the output on any of the supported browsers. First, I need to install the Angular CLI in my machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. As I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, create a new Angular project using this command, ng new project name. I named my project Angular AutoComplete. This will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, navigate to the project folder. To use the Syncfusion Angular AutoComplete, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular dropdowns package and its dependencies using this command, npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-dropdowns --save. Next, open this application in Visual Studio Code. Navigate to the app module file and import the AutoComplete module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns package. Register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Next, open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, register the Syncfusion Angular trial license key using the register license method. Syncfusion Angular license key registration is required from volume 1/2022 release onwards. Now, let me make changes in the app component HTML file by replacing its default content with the Angular AutoComplete code. Next, I will populate AutoComplete with data. First, I will open the app component TS file, define the object variable local data, and assign an array of objects that holds two fields, ID and game. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the field's property. So here, I need to define the data field's variable and map this game field to the value property. I assign this local data to the data source property and this data field's variable to the field's property. This data source contains a list of sports, so let me define the placeholder property and set the value selectAgame, which will be displayed in the component as a description. Along with this, CSS for AutoComplete should also be defined, so I import the material theme in style.css file. I will save this application and run it using the command ng-serve. Look at the AutoComplete now. When I start to type in some characters, you will see the pop-up displaying the sports names in its suggestion list, relevant to my typed-in text. Also, notice the short description, select a game as its placeholder text. Here, by default, the pop-up width will automatically adjust according to the input element's width, and default height will be 350px. To set custom height and width to the pop-up, I need to define pop-up width and pop-up height properties with custom values within this AutoComplete code. Then, I am going to define CSS style for this class element, control section, within this style.css file. Here, the pop-up is displayed with custom height and width. If I want to bind a remote data source to the Angular AutoComplete, I need to use the data manager. The data manager acts as a gateway between the AutoComplete and data source and uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. So, as a first step, I import the data manager and required adapter from the EJ2 data repository. Then, I define an instance named remote data for the data manager with properties like URL, adapter, and cross-domain. In the URL, I use the already available remote URL service, which retrieves the list of data through post action and then binds the data to the AutoComplete. This remote URL service will return a collection of data objects with fields like employee ID, first name, designation, and country. Also, I have set Web API adapter here, as the URL is already assigned with the existing Web API service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Next, I also need to map this remote data source fields, therefore, I will define an object named remote data fields and map the first name to the value field. Now, I am going to write the query to fetch the first 10 data points from the employees table, so let me import query class from the EJ2 data repository to access the query class. Then, I will define a variable data query and assign this query to fetch the data. Next, I assign these variables to the data source, fields, and query properties of the autocomplete, respectively. Along with this, I change the placeholder property value to select a name, as I have set employee names as data sources. And now, you can see the autocomplete showing employee names. To highlight my typed-in characters on the result and suggestion list, I need to define the highlight property and set its value to true. When I type the characters, autocomplete highlights the searched characters in its suggestion list like this. In this video, I showed you how to create an Angular project using Visual Studio Code and add a Syncfusion Angular autocomplete to it. I also showed you how to load JSON and remote data sources to the autocomplete. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description part below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.